Hey folks, I know sometimes in OBS you're trying to get some things just looking the way that you want to, and sometimes it's not always easy or knowing the way how to do it, so hopefully this will make it a little bit easier for you. As you can see already, I've got a lower third little graphic down here, which is the only thing on the screen. The rest of it is black. But if I wanted to put a backdrop in behind that, let me just drag and drop into OBS an image there. So I can grab the corner and I can resize it. If I'm happy with the position, that's fine. I can just click on it there, because now it's actually in front of everything else, because it's at the top of the list of sources. If I drop it to the bottom, that will then put it right at the bottom of the stack. So everything else can be built on top of that, because that's the background image that we want. Now, to get rid of those lines on the outside, if you're not going to resize it in another way, then just push the lock button and it's locked. Nice and easy. Now, I've got a camera set up here, which is a webcam, and it's actually sitting vertically because I wanted more of an image. So let me just show you, I wanted a taller image, not a wide angle image. So let's just add a video capture device, add an existing one. If you haven't got one already, create a new one, look for your camera, and then just go OK. See? Hey. So normally it will give you the wide angle version. That's exactly how you want it, because that's normally how you would set it up. But in my case, it's not quite right because it's like crooked. Well, not really crooked, but you know what I mean. So let's go to the transform menu by right clicking on the image itself or the video or whatever it is that you've got there. And we can just go rotate 90 degrees counterclockwise or clockwise. In this case, we want to go clockwise because we want it to stand straight. There we go. Now, it's obviously a little bit too big, and I can choose to crop this off just by holding down, in my case, the Option key on the Mac and scrolling or lifting that bit there up at the bottom. I could do the same with the top if I wanted, or if I'm just happy the way it is, that's fine too. So obviously, again, it's gone straight to the top of the list, and that's how it will be unless I reposition it any other way. Now, another thing you can do, just to get a little bit tricky with some things like text and or even the video itself, is I've got over here some text that is, it's over here, this one. So I've got that one vertical. It's like, well, how did you do that? Because normally when you put in text, it goes like that. Yes, it does. So again, it's exactly the same. So we'll just right click, transform, and here we go. Because it's locked, we can't do anything too much. Now you can go into this menu here, you can see it's set for minus 90 degrees in rotation. So if we just unlock that, here we go, go back to the transform menu, and there we go. Now it's the way it normally would be. So again, transform menu by right clicking, counterclockwise, and it disappears off that way. Now I've got another one over here, which is a little bit different. Let's lock that one, get it out of the way. It's on an angle. Okay, so right click again, transform, edit, transform. So this one's set for minus 35. If we took it to, say, minus 15, you watch the angle of what's going to happen. It just lowers the angle. So you can actually do that manually as well. And you can do it. It's a little bit slower, but go to the edit transform menu and you can just, it'll lift it slowly or drop it slowly, depending on what you're wanting to do. You can sort of see, if I get this out of the way, you can sort of angle it where you want to, which makes it nice and easy. There you go. So hopefully that helps you get loco soon, if you haven't got loco already. But that just make it easier, just trying to be able to reposition some of your images and text on your screen and inside of OBS. We'll catch you on another video again soon. Thanks for watching.